If for some reason chapters are not working, then I'm pinning a comment with timestamps so you can skip to the part that interests you instead of watching the entire video. If you decide to use any kind of ray tracing, then you're forced to use DirectX Ultimate. If ray tracing isn't for you, then surprisingly, DirectX 11 on average gives you the best performance. It will depend on hardware configuration, but after testing quite few, DX11 seems to be the way to go. If you have a GPU that isn't 15 years old, then you should benefit from using async compute. You can't use it with Direct 11 though, so it might be better to run Direct 12 with async compute on certain GPUs. Game screen size have nothing to do with performance, it's basically just a HUD scale. Sharpness can only be applied when using resolution scaling, and it's mostly going to be personal preference, how much of it you want to add. The most important thing is that even at 100 sharpness, you shouldn't lose any performance, maybe 0.5%. The higher you crank up the FOV slider, the more performance you are going to get. In some areas, you won't see any difference, while in others, it might be even 9% with FOV20. On average, you're going to see around 4.5% performance boost with the highest FOV. This game looks very blurry no matter if you set anti-aliasing on high or low. High is a bit sharper, but still bad. On top of that, anti-aliasing applies some weird lens distortion effect for no reason. There is a way to turn off AA through a config file, but then the game looks even worse, honestly, so I wouldn't recommend it. I'll explain the config file at the end of this video. Like I always say, motion blur in a first person game is a mistake, so turn it off for extra 2.5% performance. Particles quality changes the resolution, and since there is no performance difference between the two, just leave it on high. Sun shadows quality is a disappointing option. You either leave it as it is or you turn on ray traced shadows, which is going to annihilate your frame rate. Even though here you can see only 8.5% FPS loss, you have to remember that this number is averaged across a gameplay loop. When inside dark building and at night you lose nothing, during the day in shadow heavy area you might lose close to 20%. Contact shadows quality has almost no visible difference between highest and lowest setting and no performance gain, so I just leave it on very high. RTX Ambient Occlusion is going to devour your frame, so even though it looks really good in some places, I wouldn't recommend using it. Instead, set it to low since there is barely any difference between low and high, but you can get around 5% higher FPS on average. Another ray tracing frame gobbler, global illumination, completely changes the atmosphere in certain areas, and then in others you can't see any difference except a single digit FPS counter. No performance change between high and low, so just stick with high. Reflection quality, like its RTX brethren, won't allow for smooth frame rate even in areas where you literally can't see a single reflection, like a forest. Honestly, I would just set it to medium for that extra 7% performance boost, but don't be afraid to go all the way down to low, since 14% is quite tempting. Ray traced flashlight might give you more light in dark buildings, but I don't think it's worth losing 15% FPS when you turn it on. Fog quality, as per usual, doesn't really make too much of a visual difference between high and medium setting, so my recommendation is to go for medium here and get that extra 3% performance. You might consider going all the way down with the setting to remove that weird light beam in certain areas and make the game look cleaner. Since this game is already insanely blurry, using resolution scaling isn't a big deal. DLSS in this game is basically magic. You can easily drop Upscaler to balance mode and use some sharpener to get even sharper image than native resolution. Don't use linear mode since it just looks horrible. If on Nvidia GPU, definitely use DLSS. If AMD, then go for FSR. You can turn off anti-aliasing that Upscaler uses, which will deliver very sharp image, but fine detail like fences, etc. are going to look weird if you do so. You can also do more stuff in settings file. It's located in documents folder. Dying Light 2 out settings, and the file is called video.scr. Simply open it in any text editor, Notepad will do, and while in there, you can change texture quality, where your options are high, medium, and low. On low, you can get around 1.5% FPS boost. Grass quality doesn't really do anything to grass itself, but other smaller vegetation gets removed without noticeable performance change, so probably not worth it. But if you want to do it, then your options are 0 for highest setting, 1 for medium, and 2 for the lowest. Spot shadow map size and spot shadow quality are going to change the quality of shadows that are cast by spotlights, and there aren't many of those lights around. You could get like maybe 1.5% performance while standing next to that light, but since in your gameplay you won't see many of those, I don't really see the point. But if you want, set spotlight shadow quality to 0 and spotlight shadow map size to 256. Shadow map size can destroy all the sun's shadows, basically removing them, but not giving you any performance in return. Well, maybe 1% if you're really lucky. If you want to try that, just change the default value of 924 to something like 32 or 1. With my optimized settings, you should get around 77% higher FPS compared to high quality preset without sacrificing visuals. Just look at comparison images and try guessing which one is native resolution quality preset and which one is mine. And yes, frame rate is almost 80% higher in one of these, which you would have never guessed just by looking at the screenshots.